Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today, I will give you an OSPE, Objective Structured Practical Examination on the skull. Okay, so identify the following structures or features. What is this foramen? This is the supraorbital foramen. What are the structures which pass through this foramen or notch? Supraorbital nerve and vessels. What is the origin of the supraorbital nerve? Supraorbital nerve arises from the frontal branch of the ophthalmic nerve. Supraorbital artery from the ophthalmic artery. What is this foramen? This is the infraorbital foramen. It transmits infraorbital nerve and vessels. What is the origin of the infraorbital nerve? Infraorbital nerve is the continuation of the maxillary nerve. What is the origin of the infraorbital artery? It is a branch from the maxillary artery. What is the name of this foramen? This is the mental foramen. It transmits mental nerve and vessels. Mental nerve is a branch from the inferior alveolar nerve and the mental vessels from the inferior alveolar vessels. What is the name of this structure? This is the nasal septum. What are the parts of the nasal septum? Nasal septum is formed of three parts. The anterior part is the septal cartilage, the posterior part is the boomer, and the upper part is the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. What are these structures? This is the superior concha, this is the middle concha, and this is the inferior concha. What is the function of these conchae? They increase the surface area of the nasal cavity. Okay, what is this fissure? This is the superior orbital fissure, and this fissure, the inferior orbital fissure. Okay, what is the name of this suture? This is the sagittal suture, and this suture, coronal suture, and this suture, lambdoid suture. What is the name of this area? This is the brigma. It is the meeting between coronal suture and sagittal suture. What is the name of this area in the newborn skull? This is the anterior fontanelle. At what age the anterior fontanelle ossifies? At the 18th month, 1.5 years. What is the name of this area? This is lambda. And what is the name of this area in the newborn skull? It is the posterior fontanelle. At what age it ossifies? It ossifies at the age of 6 months. What is the shape of the two fontanelles? The anterior fontanelle is diamond shaped, the posterior fontanelle is triangular. What is the name of this foramen? It is parietal emissary foramen or parietal foramen. It transmits emissary vein between the veins of the skull and superior sagittal sinus. This is the newborn skull. Okay? What is the name of this area? Diamond shaped area. This is the anterior fontanelle. What is the name of this suture? Identify this suture. It is the metopic suture. Metopic suture, does it persist? No. It disappears at the age of 2 to 6 years, but it may persist in 8% of the population. What is the clinical importance of the persistence of the metopic suture? It may be mistaken for fracture lion in X-ray. This is norma verticalis, externa and interna. What is the name? What's your structure? Forms this groove? Superior sagittal sinus. Which structure forms these grooves? These are the branches of the middle meningeal artery. And how about these depressions? Granular fovuli, formed by what? Formed by arachnoid granulations. What is the name of this bone? Frontal bone, parietal bone, and this one, occipital bone. And again, what is the name of this area? This is the brigma, and this area, this is the lambda. Okay, this is norma occipitalis. What is the name of these bones? This is the parietal bone, and this is the occipital bone. And this suture, sagittal suture, this is the parietal foramen. This is the lambdoid suture, and this is the mastoid process, and this is the mastoid foramen. What are the structures which pass through the mastoid foramen? Artery and vein. The vein is a mystery vein between the occipital veins and the sigmoid sinus, and the artery is the meningeal branch of the occipital artery, supplying the dura of the posterior cranial fossa. What is the name of this notch? This is the mastoid notch. Which muscle takes origin or is attached here? It is the posterior belly of the digastric muscle. And again, what is the name of this area? Meeting of sagittal and lambdoid sutures. This is the lambda. And what is the name of this area? This is asterion, posterolateral fontanelle, site of the posterolateral fontanelle in the newborn skull. And what is the name of this projection? This is the external occipital protuberance. This is norma lateralis. Again, identify this bone. This is the frontal bone. This is the parietal bone. This is the occipital bone. This is the temporal squamous part of the temporal bone. This is the mastoid process. And this is the greater wing of the sphenoid. What is the name of this bone? This is the zygomatic arch. This suture, coronal suture. And this suture, lambdoid suture. And this process, this is the styloid process. And what is the name of this projection? This is the articular tubercle. What is the importance of this articular tubercle? It prevents forward displacement of the head of the mandible. It prevents dislocation of the temporomandibular joint. What is the name of this area? H-shaped area. This is the pterion. What is the clinical importance of the pterion? The pterion overlies the frontal branch or the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery. Therefore, fracture of the pterion may injure the middle meningeal artery, causing epidural hemorrhage. What is the name of this area? This is the asterion. Okay, in the newborn skull, pterion is the area of the anterolateral fontanelle. Asterion is the area of posterolateral fontanelle. Anterolateral fontanelle and posterolateral fontanelle ossify at the age of 3 months. What is the name of this triangular area? This one, it is above the external auditory meatus. It is the suprameatal triangle. Suprameatal triangle. What is the clinical importance of the suprameatal triangle? This triangle overlies the mastoid antrum or the tympanic antrum. Okay? It's very important clinically. Okay? What is the name of this process? Of course, this is the styloid process. Name three muscles attached to the styloid process and their nerve supply and give reason. So what are the three muscles attached to the styloid process? Styloglossus muscle, stylohyoid muscle, stylopharyngeus muscle. What is the nerve supply of each one? Styloglossus is supplied by the hypoglossal nerve. Stylohyoid is supplied by the facial nerve. Stylopharyngeus is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Why the styloglossus is supplied by the hypoglossal nerve? Because styloglossus muscle develops from occipital myotomes. And these occipital myotomes are supplied by the hypoglossal nerve. Why the stylohyoid muscle is supplied by the facial nerve? Because it develops from the second pharyngeal arch. Why the stylopharyngeus muscle is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve? Because it develops from the third pharyngeal arch. This is norma basalis externa. Let us see some foramina. What is the name of this fossa or foramen, incisive fossa? What are the structures which pass through the incisive fossa? Nasopalatine nerve and sphenopalatine artery. About this foramen, this is the greater palatine foramen. It transmits greater palatine nerve and vessels. Greater palatine nerve is a branch from the sphenopalatine ganglion attached to the maxillary nerve. What is this foramen? This is foramen ovale. I will go back to it. And this foramen, foramen spinosum. And this foramen, this is the carotid canal. It transmits the internal carotid artery. And what are these foramina? What is this foramen and this foramen? This foramen, between the mastoid process and the styloid process. Between mastoid process and the styloid process. So this is the stylomastoid foramen. What are the structures which pass through the stylomastoid foramen? Nerve and artery. What is the nerve? Facial nerve. What is the artery? Stylomastoid artery, branch from the posterior auricular artery. Again, stylomastoid foramen transmits nerve and artery. Nerve, facial nerve. Artery, stylomastoid artery. This stylomastoid artery is a branch from the posterior auricular artery. It supplies the facial nerve, actually. Okay. Name three arteries passing through this foramen. This is foramen magnum. It transmits the two vertebral arteries entering the cranial cavity, anterior spinal artery descending down, and the posterior spinal arteries. So vertebral, anterior spinal, and the posterior spinal arteries. What is the name of this plate? This is the lateral pterygoid plate. Name two muscles attached to the lateral pterygoid plate. Medial pterygoid and the lateral pterygoid muscles. What is this? This is the occipital condyle. What is the name of the joint formed by the occipital condyle? It is the atlanto-occipital joint. What is the type of the atlanto-occipital joint? It is a synovial joint, ellipsoid variety. This is norma basalis interna. What is the name of this foramen? This is foramen cecum. It transmits emissary vein between superior sagittal sinus and the veins of the nose. What is the name of this plate? This is the cribriform plate of ethmoid. It transmits olfactory nerves. How about this canal? This is the optic canal. It transmits artery and nerve. Of course, the nerve is the optic nerve, and the artery is the ophthalmic artery. And this ophthalmic artery is a branch from the internal carotid artery. This is the internal carotid artery. This is the superior orbital fissure. Superior orbital fissure, it transmits from above downward, okay, branches of ophthalmic nerve, trochlear nerve, oculomotor nerve, and ophthalmic veins. Okay, and abducens nerve also. So, live free to see no insult at all. L is the lacrimal nerve. F is the frontal nerve. T, trochlear nerve. Superior division of the oculomotor nerve. Nasociliary nerve. Inferior division of the oculomotor nerve. Abducens nerve. And ophthalmic veins. The first three structures, lacrimal, frontal, and trochlear nerves, run inside the tendinous ring. The others run outside the tendinous ring. Lacrimal, frontal, and the nasociliary are branches of the ophthalmic nerve. What is this foramen? This is foramen rotundum. It transmits this nerve. What is this nerve? This is a maxillary nerve. About this foramen. This is foramen ovale. It reminds me by the word male. Mandibular nerve. Accessory meningeal artery. Lesser petrosal nerve. And the emissary vein. Connecting the cavernous sinus with the pterygoid and the pharyngeal plexus. So, what are the two nerves passing through foramen ovale? The two nerves passing through foramen ovale are mandibular nerve and the lesser petrosal nerve. This is foramen spinosum. Foramen spinosum transmits artery and nerve. The artery is the middle meningeal artery. The nerve is nervus spinosus from the mandibular nerve to supply the dura mater of the middle cranial fossa. This is the internal auditory meatus. It transmits two nerves and artery, the two nerves, facial and vestibulocochlear nerves, and the labyrinthine artery from the basilar artery. This is the jugular foramen. Jugular foramen transmits three nerves and two veins. The three nerves, 9, 10, and 11, glossopharyngeal, pharyngeal, vagus, and the accessory. And the two nerves, inferior petrosal sinus and the sigmoid sinus, to continue as the internal jugular vein. This is foramen magnum. It transmits three nervous structures, three arteries, and three meningeal layers. The three nervous structures, medulla oblongata, to continue as the spinal cord, a spinal accessory nervous, going into the cranial cavity, and the cervical branches of the cervical nerves from the upper four cervical nerves to supply the dura of the posterior cranial fossa. The three arteries, vertebral arteries, anterior spinal artery, and the posterior spinal arteries. And the three meninges, of course, dura, arachnoid, and pia. This is the hypoglossal canal. It transmits the hypoglossal nerve. This is the cranial cavity. Okay, again, this is foramen cecum. This is the sphenoparietal sinus. Sphenoparietal sinus draining into the cavernous sinus. So identify this sinus. This is the cavernous sinus. What are the four nerves in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus? These are the four nerves in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Otum, oculomotor, trochlear, ophthalmic, and maxillary nerves. Oculomotor, trochlear, ophthalmic, and maxillary nerves. What are the structures inside the cavernous sinus? Artery and nerve. This artery is the internal carotid artery, and this nerve is the abducens nerve. This one. What is the name of this dural sinus? This is the superior petrosal sinus. What is the name of this sinus? This is the left transverse sinus. What is the origin of the left transverse sinus? It is the continuation of the straight sinus. So this is the straight sinus. What is the origin of the right transverse sinus? The right transverse sinus is a continuation of the superior sagittal sinus. What is this sinus? This is the sigmoid sinus, which is the continuation of the transverse sinus. What is this nerve? This is the sensory root of the trigeminal nerve. What is this? This is the trigeminal ganglion. It gives three branches. This is the ophthalmic nerve. This is the maxillary nerve. And this is the mandibular nerve. Again, remember, otum, oculomotor, trochlear, ophthalmic, and the maxillary nerves run in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. What is then this nerve? This is the optic nerve. What is the origin of this artery? First, what is this artery? This is the ophthalmic artery. What is the origin of the ophthalmic artery? Internal carotid artery. What is the name of this fold? This is the tentorium cerebelli or cerebelli. What is the origin of this nerve? What is this nerve? This is the optic nerve. What is the origin? It's formed by the axons of the ganglion cells of the retina. This is the mandible. Okay, what is the name of this lion? This is the myelohyoid lion. Name two muscles attached to the myelohyoid lion. Of course, myelohyoid muscle and the posterior end gives origin to the superior constrictor. So myelohyoid muscle and the superior constrictor. Which muscle is attached here? This is the medial pterygoid muscle. And the muscle attached here, the temporalis muscle. Which gland is related to this area above myelohyoid line? Sublingual salivary gland. Which gland is related to this area below the myelohyoid line? This is the submandibular salivary gland. What is the name of this groove? This is the myelohyoid groove. It transmits myelohyoid nerve and vessels. What are the muscles supplied by the nerve to myelohyoid? Of course, myelohyoid muscle and the anterior belly of the digastric muscle. Which structure is related to this groove? Actually, this is the dangerous position of this nerve. This groove is formed by the lingual nerve below the last molar. Lingual nerve is here. Which nerve is related to the medial side of the neck of the mandible? This is the auriculotemporal nerve. Which artery? This is the first part of the maxillary artery. So what are structures related to the neck of the mandible? Medial side. Auriculotemporal nerve and the first part of the maxillary artery. What is the name of this projection? This is the lingula. Which ligament is attached to the lingula? It is the sphenomandibular ligament. Which ligament is attached to the posterior border of the angle of the mandible? A stylomandibular ligament. Which ligament is attached to the myelohyoid line? It is the trigomandibular ligament. Trigomandibular ligament is attached to the myelohyoid line between myelohyoid muscle and the superior constrictor. What are the structures which pass through the mandibular foramen? This is the mandibular foramen. Artery and the nerve. Inferior alveolar artery and the inferior alveolar nerve. Again, this is the mandible. Which muscle is attached here? Here is the masseter muscle. What is the action of the masseter? Elevation and the protrusion of the mandible. What is the nerve supply of the masseter? It is nerve to masseter from the mandibular nerve. Which muscle is inserted here? This is the medial pterygoid muscle. It has the same action as the masseter, okay, plus side-to-side movement of the mandible. Which muscle is attached here? This is the lateral pterygoid. And the muscle attached here, this is the temporalis muscle, supplied by the mandibular nerve. Which muscle is attached here? This is the buccinator. What is the nerve supply? Facial nerve. Why supplied by the facial nerve? because it develops from the second differential arch. Which muscle supply is inserted here or is attached here? So is attached here. This is a platysma muscle. Okay, identify the vertebra. This is the typical cervical vertebra. Typical cervical vertebra. First, it is cervical because it has foramen in the transverse process. It is typical short spine, which is bifid. So this is the typical cervical vertebra, which is from number 3 to number 6. So this is cervical vertebra from number 3 to number 6. This is the second cervical vertebra, atlas. How do you know? Because of this process, odontoid process or the dense. What is this vertebra? This is the seventh cervical vertebra. How do you know? It has a long spine, which is and not bifid. Long spine, not bifid. Okay? This is the seventh cervical. So how about this one? This is the first atlas. It doesn't have body. It has anterior arch and posterior arch. So this is the first. This is the second. This is from number 3 to number 6. And this is the seventh. Okay, this groove above the posterior arch of the atlas related to two structures, nerve and artery. What is this nerve? This is the suboccipital nerve. So what is the suboccipital nerve? Suboccipital nerve is the dorsal ramus of C1. And what is this artery? This is the vertebral artery. Which part of the vertebral artery above the posterior arch of the atlas? It is the third part of the vertebral artery. Regarding the axis, what is the type of this joint? This joint between the axis and the atlas here. So it is the median atlanto-axial joint. What is the type of the median atlanto-axial joint? It is synovial of pivot variety. What is the name of this? This is articular fossa for the articulation of the occipital condyle, atlanto-occipital joint, ellipsoid, synovial joint. How about this one? This facet articulates with the axis to form a lateral atlanto-axial joint. This lateral atlanto-axial joint is plane synovial joint. What is the type of this joint between the bodies of the vertebrae? Intervertebral disc, secondary cartilaginous joint. Again, secondary cartilaginous joint. Which structure passes through this foramen, vertebral artery? And through this foramen, okay guys, this is the seventh cervical vertebra. It doesn't transmit the vertebral artery, but it transmits the accessory vertebral vein. Again, this is the vertebral artery, for the vertebral artery. And thank you very much, best wishes and good luck, and see you later.